Lesson 92. Miracles are seen in light, and light and strength are one. The idea for today is an extension of the previous one. You do not think of light in terms of strength and darkness in terms of weakness. That is because your idea of what seeing means is tied up with the body and its eyes and brain. This is why you believe that you can change what you see by keeping little bits of glass or other clear material before your eyes, held in a frame or placed against the eye. These are among the many magical beliefs that come from the conviction you are a body and the body's eyes can see. You also believe the body's brain can think. If you but understood the nature of thought, you could but laugh at this insane idea. It is as if you thought you held the match that lights the sun and gives it all its warmth, or that you held the universe within your hand, securely bound until you let it go. Yet this is no more foolish than to believe the body's eyes can see, the brain can think. It is God's strength in you that is the light in which you see, as it is His mind with which you think. His strength denies your weakness. It is your weakness that sees through the body's eyes, peering about in darkness to behold the likeness of itself, the small, the weak, the sickly and the dying, those in need, the helpless and afraid, the sad, the poor, the starving, and the useless. These are seen through eyes which cannot see and cannot bless. Strength overlooks these things by seeing past appearances. It keeps its steady gaze upon the light that lies beyond them. It unites with light of which it is a part. It sees itself. It brings the light in which yourself appears. In darkness, you perceive a self that is not there. Strength is the truth about you. Weakness is an idol falsely worshipped and adored that strength may be dispelled and darkness rule where God appointed that there should be light. Strength comes from truth and shines with light its source has given it. Weakness reflects the darkness of its maker. It is sick and looks on sickness, which is like itself. Truth is a savior and can only will for happiness and peace for everyone. It gives its strength to everyone who asks, in limitless supply. It sees that lack in anyone would be a lack in all, and so it gives its light that all may see and benefit as one. Its strength is shared, that it may bring to all the miracle in which they will unite in purpose and forgiveness and in love. Weakness, which looks in darkness, cannot see a purpose in forgiveness and in love. It sees all others different from itself, and nothing in the world which it would share. It judges and condemns, but does not love. In darkness it remains to hide itself, and dreams that it is strong and conquering, a victor over limitations, which but grow in darkness, to enormous size. It fears, and it attacks, and hates itself, and darkness covers everything it sees. No miracles are here, but only hate. It separates itself from what it sees, while light and strength perceive themselves as one. The light of strength is not the light you see. It does not change and flicker and go out. It does not shift from night to day and back to darkness till the morning comes again. The light of strength is constant, sure as love, forever glad to give itself away because it cannot give but to itself. No one can ask in vain to share its sight. And none who enters its abode can leave without a miracle before his eyes, and strength and light abiding in his heart. The strength in you will offer you the light and guide your seeing, so you do not dwell on idle shadows which the body's eyes provide for self-deception. Strength and light unite in you, and where they meet, your self stands ready to embrace you as its own. Such is the meeting place we try today to find and rest in, for the peace of God is where yourself, His Son, is waiting now to meet itself again and be as one. Let us give 20 minutes twice today to join this meeting. Let yourself be brought unto yourself. Its strength will be the light in which the gift of sight is given you. Leave then the dark a little while today, and we will practice seeing in the light, closing body's eyes and asking truth to show us how to find the meeting place of self and self, where light and strength are one. Morning and evening we will practice thus. After the morning meeting, we will use the day in preparation for the time at night, when we will meet again in hope and trust. Let us repeat as often as we can the idea for today, and recognize that we are being introduced to sight and led away from darkness to the light, where only miracles can be perceived.